keep on shelling her to stop that tank.
Note to self, avoid explosive barrels. Almost out of commission. Oh yeah, I'll grab the eye while Carmelita's still stuck in her tank, then come around to pick up Bentley for a quick exit.
Do what you can, Sly. We'll all hook up at the rendezvous for extraction.
There's nowhere left to run. We both know I can beat you in a fight. So why don't you just hand over the eye?
You're right, Cooper. In a battle of strength, you've proven yourself. But with this clockwork eye, I can battle in your mind.
Got a strong mind, Cooper. I never would have guessed.
Things hadn't gone exactly to plan, but the Contessa was beaten and the clockwork eyes were finally mine. The Contessa was arrested and brought to trial for the crime she committed while working for Interpol. Their PR damage control went one step further by promoting Neela, the hero of Prague, to the rank of captain. Carmelita, still on the outs with Interpol, had to run with the rest of us. To my surprise and eternal delight, I got to help my favorite policewoman escape from the cops. I tried to put it all out of my mind. This claw business was spiraling out of control, and I knew that my gang was at the center of it. We'd be back in action soon enough, but for now, well, we just laid low for a while. Trail of spice shipments, we made our way up to Nunavut Bay, Canada, the secret hub of Jean Bisson's shipping empire. As a young man, he trekked across Canada to strike it rich during the gold rush of 1852. An avid prospector, he took some chances and ended up buried alive in an avalanche. Miraculously, the quick freeze kept him alive, and 120 years later, thanks to global warming, he thawed out. A product of his time, he dreams of taming the wild north, damming every river and chopping down all the trees, with progress delivered at the sharp end of an axe. Shipping spice for the Claw Gang proved a lucrative way to bankroll his one-man war against nature. And yet, I have to feel a little sorry for him. He's just a normal guy from the 1850s. Back in his day, he'd be a hero, but today, he's a villain. Either way, that man's got more than his fair share of the clockwork parts. What a low-tech guy like Jean Bassan is doing with robot parts is a mystery. I almost don't want to know. But as always, it's only a matter of time before I find out.
into the wilderness.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ransacking his files doesn't sound hard. Now, climbing up a sheer rock wall? That'll be a challenge.
You're in luck. Before Jean Bisson took over, this used to be a popular destination for rock climbers. Some of their old wall hooks are still around.
I'm guessing I just jump and hit the circle button to latch on.
That's right. And remember to lean back before you spring off the hook. You'll get more altitude.
Thanks for the tip. I'll give it a try.
Jackpot, Sly! That's Jean Bisson!
Looks like he didn't.